those guys comfortable, in terms of where they want the ball, how they like playing. I think his first inclination is, it's his job to get those other guys involved and get them playing, and I think that's what he tries to do all the time. Anthony hasn't been to the playoffs since 2013, and George and Westbrook both had short postseason runs last season, but if this experiment failed, the bulk of the blame would fall on the guy who flaunts his pectorals with tattered sweatshirts and asks, why not? Westbrook would never express the pressures he felt, but his play suggested otherwise. He missed a huge chunk of training camp because of a platelet-rich plasma procedure in his left knee and needed some time to regain his rhythm. Likewise, George and Anthony had to get in where they fit in, an unusual assignment for players accustomed to having teammates assume those roles around them. You got somebody else on your side who is going to go to war with you, going to compete with you. Somebody who wants to win, just as bad as you. That makes this process fun, joyful and makes it exciting, Anthony told Yahoo Sports. Coming in, we all knew what we wanted to do. We all knew the goal. It was just, how are we going to go about that? I think now, we done found that rhythm, found that flow and everybody accepted that. Westbrook's passion and intensity are often misinterpreted because he isn't some angry, tunnel-visioned loner. He is demanding, but he's also harder on himself, which made the early stumbles frustrating. Not only did Westbrook have to contend with criticism for the Thunder's slow start, but he was also blamed for holding back former teammates like Victor Oladipo, Domantas Sabonis, and Enes Kanter, who have all blossomed since leaving him behind. Donovan believes the whole exercise in Russ bashing, and the claim that he couldn't play nice with others, was misguided.